Welcome! This is another one of Erudition's PAT walkthrough videos. In this video, we're going to be running you through top front end problems where the objects have various protruding elements, cutouts, and other edges that you're going to need to know how to analyze for your PAT. Before we get into the problems, let's do a brief overview of what these kinds of features look like in the different views. Say you have an object like this, an object like this, and an object like this. If you're given just the top view of each of these objects, you'd never know whether this main circular feature was a cutout into the object or something protruding out of the object. But in top front-end problems, you're always given two views, so at least one of the views you're given will make it clear what kind of a feature you're looking at. For these objects, either the front view or the end view is going to make it clear that this is a protruding element, this is a cutout that goes only this far through the object, and this is a cutout that goes all the way through the object. Notice also that protrusions and cutouts in top front-end problems may have different 3D shapes, and each of these shapes may look different when viewed from a different direction. Cylindrical protrusions and holes may look circular when seen straight on, but will look rectangular when seen from another view, just like actually rectangular protrusions and cutouts. And oval-shaped protrusions and oval-shaped cutouts also will look rectangular when you're not looking at them straight on. And there are a ton of different shapes for protrusions and cutouts that you'll end up seeing on your DAT, and quite a few of them will look rectangular when seen from certain views. So before we get into some top front-end example problems, let's do a brief run-through of an object that has a lot of different kinds of features. Notice first that the ramp at the front of this object appears rectangular in both the top view and the front view. That's because this face is the only thing of that ramp that's visible from those views. This rounded section appears rectangular in the top view, where it matches the width of the component in the front view. And it also appears rectangular in the end view, where it matches the height of the component in the front view. Then we can notice that a triangular cutout, like this one, will appear rectangular from certain views. In this case, the front view and the end view. In the front view, you can see that the triangular cutout accounts for these three hidden edges, corresponding to the three points of the triangle. And lastly, notice that there are two horizontal hidden edges that run across the object from side to side. This one is depicted as a dotted line in the top view, and this one is depicted by a dotted line in the front view. Now that we've looked at a few objects and seen what their views would look like, we can shift our attention to some actual top front end problems and use the views given to deduce the missing view. Let's start with a problem where you have to assess whether something is a cutout or a protrusion, and also one with some extra additional edges thrown in. I chose this problem from our level 2 question banks, and it gives you the top view and the front view and asks you to find the end view. As you can see from the views that were given, this main part of the object seems fairly tall, but relatively shallow from front to back. And if we look over to the possible answers, each one of these matches those dimensions. Now, the front view shows two features that face the front of the object. But you can't tell just from the front view alone whether these features are cutting into the object or protruding out. So we'll have to look to the other view. In the top view, you can tell that this smaller element on the right protrudes out from the object. And remember, in the top view, this area is the front of the object. In the front view, this element is fairly short and sits towards the bottom of the object. So, based on those criteria, we can eliminate choice A and choice D. Choice A has no protruding elements, and the protruding element in D is far too tall and sits too high up. Next, let's look at the element on the left. The dotted lines in the top view show that this element is a cutout that goes all the way through the object, from front to back. Notice, though, that there are actually three dotted lines in the top view. And that's because this one actually corresponds to this edge here at the bottom of the object, marked in blue. When we're looking for our correct answer, we should also be looking for dotted lines that correspond to the edges of this cutout. Both choice B and choice C have pairs of dotted lines that match this pretty well. But notice how this edge all the way on the left would also create a dotted line in the end view, which means that choice C has to be wrong because it does not include this line. So B is our correct answer. Now, even though we know B is correct from process of elimination, you may be wondering about this edge. Well, this object is unique because it has this curved top. And that means that this right edge actually sits below the top of the object slightly. And that creates this kind of double edge at the top. So in case you were wondering, that's where that comes from. So you could look out for it in the future. And knowing that extra detail just continues to confirm that choice B is correct. So let's see. Yep, perfect. And now if we look down to the 3D graphics in our explanation, we can see all of those edges that we discussed. Notice here how the animation shows that curved top and why it makes that double edge in the end view. And you can also see that hidden edge from the bottom of the object and the one at the far left. Whether you get a problem right or wrong, our explanations will walk you all the way through the process after the fact and hopefully clear up any questions you have. Let's try another one. This is a problem from our level 1 question banks. Although this is a relatively simple looking shape, we've actually found that quite a few of our students struggle with this problem, so let's review it. When an object has multiple features like this, it can be really helpful to focus on where each individual feature sits relative to the other features. Let's start by looking at this box, which is the main feature of the object. The front view shows how wide it is, and the end view shows how deep it is. And the main box portion of each of our answer choices also have these dimensions. You can also tell from the end view that these two large circular features project out in front of the box. And these two projections are also seen in each of our answer choices. And notice, when we look in the end view, the front of the box ends right here, and the circular features do not extend into it. All of the answer choices show this fact pretty well, except for choice A. It seems to show the edges of these features extending in and through the object. So because of that, we can eliminate choice A. Now notice that there's also a cutout at the bottom of the object. The top of this cutout accounts for this dotted line in the end view. And this shows that the cutout runs all the way from the front of the box to the back of the box. Now the bottom two edges of this cutout should account for two dotted lines in the top view. But which of these answers shows that correctly? Well, first of all, we should notice that the cutout only goes through the box itself, so it stops at the front of the box. This is shown accurately in choice B and choice D, but notice that in choice C, those edges actually continue forward, in which case we can eliminate choice C. Next, you'll notice that these edges in choice B and choice D, the gap between them is different in each answer choice, with the lines in choice B actually lining up with the gap in between the projections at the front of the object, while the lines in choice D are a bit wider. For subtle position differences like this, it can be really helpful to focus on the relative position of the different features. For example, notice in the front view that the inner edges of these circular projections sit about this close to each other, while the bottom edges of this cutout are a bit farther apart. The positions of these features relative to one another better match the positioning seen in choice D, in which case we can eliminate choice B. And it looks like we're correct. Let's look down at our graphics again. You can really see in this model that it's these bottom edges of the cutout that are seen in the top view. And this GIF down here also really helps to show the relative positions of the cutout and the two circular projections at the front. We're starting to kind of get the hang of it now. Let's try another example. I want to go over this next problem to show some of the finer nuances of top front end problems. Notice that all of the answer choices have essentially the same overall shape, but there's just a few small details that are different. So the question is, which details are correct? What we can see first is that the top view and the end view show that there must be essentially one large flat face forming the front of the object. And we can tell that because it's totally flat here and totally flat here. So that means there's just one large face at the front of the object, and that face is this tall and this wide. Looking at the answer choices, we can see that most of them have this large face. It's really only choice A that differs. It can't be choice A because choice A has this ledge right here, which actually suggests that this top part is not fully flush with this bottom section. If it's a little hard to understand what I mean, choice A could be an object that looks something like this, or possibly this, or this. And none of those are completely flat at the front in the top view and the end view. So it's pretty clear that we're going to have to eliminate choice A. Now, choice C, though it does have a large flat face at the front, it has these other solid lines near the bottom. Solid lines like this imply that something must be either jutting out of the object or cutting in. In order to make a front view like choice C, the object would have to look something like this, or even this with some slanted ramps, or possibly like this with cutouts that only go partway through the object. Unless the object had some of these features, it wouldn't have these bottom edges. But in all these options that could create edges like that, there are features either sticking out or partially cutting in, and neither of those things can be seen in the top and end views of the actual problem. So, we gotta eliminate choice C. With that, we have two answers left. So let's think. In the top view that we're given, it shows that there are these hidden edges that run all the way through the object from the front to the back. And you'll notice that the positions of these edges match up pretty darn well to the two cutouts at the bottom of both of our possible answers. And these cutouts also account for the dotted lines that run across the end view. You can see that the top of this shorter cutout sits here, and the taller one sits right here. And that final hidden edge is accounted for by this large ledge at the top of each answer. But choice B has something extra. It has this dotted line that runs across the right side of the object. And it simply isn't accounted for by anything we can see in the top view or end view. You can see in the top view that all the edges run all the way from the front to the back. There's no bends or turns that would create this mysterious edge in choice B. So, with that, we can eliminate choice B, and that leaves choice D as our final answer. And once again, we're correct. And this 3D model shows that this large front face is completely flat with nothing sticking out of it and no denser edges in it. And that these cutouts, marked in blue, run all the way through the object from front to back. And you can see it again here in this animation of the object. Alright, let's step it up a notch to an object with a lot of different features. This is from our level 2 question bank. When you see a problem like this, it can be very overwhelming. There's just so much going on. It's best to just stay calm and pick one feature, one single feature to start with, and see if you can use it to eliminate an answer or two. For this one, let's start with the top. In the views, the object has a little top feature here, and each of the answer choices seem to have their own unique top. So let's see which ones work with the views that we're given. You can see that there are four vertical lines visible from both the front view and the end view for this part of the object. It looks like these lines could correspond to the shape at the top of choice B and the one at the top of choice C. The front view and the end view would appear the way they are if this top shape were either a short octagonal column, like in choice B, or a raised cross shape, like in choice C. Both of them work perfectly well for these four edges in the front view and for these four edges in the end view. Choice A and choice D, on the other hand, just have these straight lines running from front to back, which do not sufficiently explain the vertical edges seen in the front view and the end view. So, just like that, we can eliminate choice A and choice D, and all we looked at was one feature. Next, we'll probably want to look at the sides of choice B and choice C, because those features are very different from one another, and pretty much everything else about these two answer choices looks about the same. You'll see in the end view that there's just a flat surface at the end of the object. There's no visible cutout or feature that extends into that surface. So even just from that, it's pretty likely that choice C is incorrect, because it implies that there's some sort of hidden cutout that cuts in from the side of the object. If this were true, it would create a visible edge in our end view, which we don't see here. What we do see in the end view are these dotted lines, and they seem to match this feature that's seen in the front view. It's about the same height as the dotted lines, and would hide neatly behind this larger section on the right. And this all corresponds pretty well to the features that are seen in choice B. You'll notice that this feature is just as wide in choice B as it is in the end view. I think it's safe then for us to choose choice B as our answer. And what do you know? Correct. And notice here in our 3D model that this part, marked in blue, corresponds perfectly to what's shown in the front view and the end view. and this is animation of the object. Okay, that was a lot of problems with a lot of great tips. So let's do a recap. You'll want to look at both available views to determine whether a feature protrudes out or cuts in to the object. Make sure you also try and account for all of the edges that are present in the missing view. Be sure to examine the relative position of edges, where they sit in relation to one another. It's often helpful to look for differences in the answer choices and to see which of them have extra or missing features that just don't make sense. For complex problems with a lot going on, try to pick individual features and see if you can use them to eliminate answer choices. All right, that's all for our first video on top front-end strategies. Keep a lookout for our next video. It's going to be on holes and complex cutouts. Don't forget to sign up for our course for access to more DAT problems, helpful 3D models, and detailed step-by-step solutions. Look out for yourself, and I'll see you in the next video.